I've got this image of Baby Yoda here, and I'm about to process it using VFusion3D, which is the latest 3D reconstruction model developed by Meta and Oxford. The model takes this 2D image, and in only about 16 seconds it transforms it into a full 3D mesh, just like that. Just from a single picture, the model predicts views from all possible angles, estimating both the volume and colors. Now we can use this 3D mesh for any sort of digital content creation, or we can also print it. And here it is! We've just turned a single image into a 3D printed model with almost no effort. We can see some imperfections like the dendrite here, but the rest looks good. The ears are slightly curved as they should be, and the scarf continues all around his neck. So the reconstruction model I just used transforms that single image of Grogu into something called Neural Radiance Field, or NeRF, which is a widely used technique in vision now. NeRF models basically learn how light interacts with the scene. And once trained, they can then predict the colors and densities of every point in the 3D space, even from completely new views. But typically you wouldn't train a NeRF using just one image. Instead you would use multiple images of a scene from different angles, allowing the model to learn how light behaves from different perspectives. If you watched my previous video about Zip-NeRF, you might remember me taking about 70 images of this Grogu Funko Pop to train my NeRF model. During the training, NeRF tries to predict the colors and densities and is trained to minimize the difference between these predictions and the real colors from the photos we took. And as you can see here, it eventually learned to represent the scene quite well. Once the model is trained, you can do something called view synthesis and render completely new views that weren't in the original training photos. For example, look at this walkthrough of a house created by a NeRF model. No recorded video was used here, just a collection of still images from different angles and perspectives. So this is pretty cool, but you have to actually be in that scene and manually capture all those images. Now compare that to simply downloading a photo of Grogu from the internet and pressing a single button like I just did. And of course, a single photo reconstruction doesn't work for every application. For something like a house walkthrough, you probably want to use lots of photos to make sure that everything in the house is represented accurately. But if you're okay with the model filling in a few details, single image reconstruction can be incredibly fast and useful. Let me show you just how useful this can be. For example, say I want to 3D print chess pieces for this chessboard. And I used to like playing this Star Wars themed chess game when I was young, so let's do something similar and design each chess piece as a Star Wars character. Oh, by the way, this is what happens when you capture pieces in this game. They start violently fighting each other. Now, I could search the internet for images that look like Star Wars chess characters, but I will actually do something much simpler and generate them from text with Midjourney. After about 5 minutes of playing with prompts, I came up with these images for each chess piece. And I think they turned out pretty well, what do you think? All I need to do now is to feed the images into my reconstruction model, generate a mesh for each chess piece, and print everything. Okay, that was fairly easy, right? But let's look at the quality of these meshes and printed pieces. And let's start with the chess king, which is supposed to look like Vader. I think it looks very good. Let's ignore the colors now, because that's not really the task we're interested in, and we can always paint it. The important thing is the shape, and I think the model nailed it. It's not too thin, it's not too bulky, it makes sense as a chess piece. What I dislike is the face part here. I think it needs more detail, and that's kind of the same problem I have with the Queen Amidala here. So I would definitely say it needs more detail around the eyes and mouth, right? And actually, let's quickly check the generated mesh, so that you can see it's not just caused by printing. Yeah, it's the same problem. It lacks detail in the eye area and the crown as well, actually. The C-3PO Bishop looks good, but I wish the front and back parts were not so bumpy. When you look at the original image, it should actually be very smooth. My guess here is that all the reflection in the input image confuses the model. So this one is supposed to be Jar Jar, and I was very curious about this one, because it's not the usual shape, and in the original image, it's looking a little bit sideways. But I think the model did a decent job here. The R2-D2 Rook is the only piece I really don't like. That's because it failed to model the top part here, which is supposed to look like a castle tower. And that's kind of the iconic part of the Rook piece. When you look closely, you cannot see the gaps here at all. I mean, gaps. What is this called on a castle wall?
So if you're unaware, this is called crenellations. Okay, it's a crenellated wall, and it is comprised of a tooth, which is the merlon, and a gap in between, which is called the crenel.
Yes, so as I was saying, what I don't like about this model is that you cannot tell apart the individual crenels and merlons on the top part of the rook. And the last one is the spawn, and this one could be hard to model because as you can see, it is not symmetrical. The arms are going back, and the model has to infer this from the 2D image. It could have a bit more detail in the face again, but otherwise this is a very nice piece. So overall, I really like my new chess set, and remember, this is how it looks now. But given how fast AI is progressing, this can look substantially better a few months or year from now. So I guess what I'm trying to say is hit the subscribe button if you want to see updates on this topic. Wait a minute, why are all the pieces white? Oh, because this chess can only be played at night. So we have just seen what single image reconstruction can do and how it differs from standard NeRF modeling with many images. But how does it actually work? There are two research papers on this topic that I think are good to know about. The first one is LRM by Hong and colleagues. The work presents the first large-scale 3D reconstruction model, and it's basically the first attempt to bring transformers into this field. And here's the model architecture. At a very high level, LRM takes a single image, passes it through a visual transformer to extract important features, and then uses another transformer to decode these features and generate NeRF. We can then do volumetric rendering and synthesize images from different views. There are many interesting details in this architecture, such as the triplane representation right here, so if you're interested in this topic, I highly recommend diving into this paper. This model was trained on a dataset with about 1 million 3D objects, and it shows promising results compared to other reconstruction models, such as 123-45. However, LRM has its limitations, and the paper reports examples of distorted and blurry regions in some cases. And one of the ways to improve 3D generative modeling is to train it on more data. That's actually one of the main challenges in this field. Although 1 million training examples for LRM might sound like a lot, it pales in comparison to language models like GPT, which are trained on datasets with billions of samples. And so Han and colleagues address this data limitation in their paper VFusion3D. That's the model I used in all my experiments. Their solution revolves around using the video diffusion model EMU, which was introduced in this paper. EMU is a model that can generate high-quality videos just from text, and so we can use it to generate videos where the camera rotates around different objects. And that's perfect because that effectively gives us a multi-view image generator, and then we can generate lots of synthetic data for training. The authors of this paper then used about 3 million synthetic multi-view data and trained their model, which has almost the same architecture as LRM. And the paper compares VFusion3D to other models, including our old friend LRM, and we can see some notable improvements in these examples. So that was single image 3D reconstruction. Please let me know in the comments below what you think, and thank you for watching.